Phew! All that singing has made us a bit tired. I think it's time to sit and listen to Lizzie tell you a story.
Maisie, this is the story of Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Are you ready? Goldilocks and the Three Bears. This is a story of Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Goldilocks was a pretty little girl with long golden curls. Her father was a woodcutter, and every morning she would walk through the forest to take him his lunch. Goldilocks knew the forest well as you might know the street where you live, and enjoyed meeting all the animals and birds. Although her father did warn her that not all the animals were as friendly as she was. Deep in the forest, there lived a family of bears. There was Daddy Bear, Mummy Bear, and Baby Bear. It was a bright sunny day, so the bears were up early. Daddy Bear had made some porridge with honey and was pouring it into bowls. But the porridge was far too hot to eat straight away. "Let's go for a walk and pick some mushrooms while our porridge cools down," suggested Mummy Bear. So out of the house walked Daddy Bear, Mummy Bear, and Baby Bear. But Baby Bear forgot to shut the door behind him. Meanwhile, Goldilocks had taken a different route through the forest that morning, when she smelt something delicious. She followed the smell to a cute wooden cottage. It was the bear's cottage, and it was their porridge she could smell. Although she knew it was naughty, Goldilocks poked her head round the kitchen door and tiptoed inside. She saw a dresser with jars of honey on its shelves, and three steaming bowls of porridge left on the table. "Is anyone home?" she called. There was no answer. By now, she was hungry, so she tried the porridge in Daddy Bear's large bowl. "Ow! This porridge is far too hot," she said, dropping the spoon. Next, she tried the porridge in Mummy Bear's middle-sized bowl. "This porridge is far too cold." Finally, she tried the porridge in Baby Bear's tiny bowl. "This porridge is just right." And she ate it all up. She felt quite at home, so she went to sit down. In one corner of the room was a huge chair. It was Daddy Bear's chair, and she climbed up onto it. "Oh dear, this chair is far too hard," she said. Next, she tried a chair in the other corner of the room. It was Mummy Bear's chair. "Nope, this chair is far too soft," as she wriggled and all the cushions fell off it. In the middle was a smaller chair. Goldilocks squeezed herself into the chair. "This feels perfect." But Goldilocks was too heavy for Baby Bear's chair, and it snapped and gave way.
Whoa!
She landed with a bump on the floor. Goldilocks needed to rest before she started walking again, so she climbed up the rickety stairs and found the bear's bedroom. First, Goldilocks tried Daddy Bear's big bed.
"This bed is far too hard and lumpy," she said.
Then she tried Mummy Bear's feather bed.
"This bed is far too soft."
At last, she found a comfy bed. Can you guess whose it was? That's right. It was Baby Bear's bed. It was a tight fit, but Goldilocks snuggled down quickly. she yawned as she pulled the covers under her chin. Soon she was fast asleep and dreaming. After a few minutes, the bears arrived back at their cottage to find the door wide open. "Baby bear, I told you to always close the door behind you," scolded Mummy Bear.
"Sorry, Mummy."
They were really looking forward to their breakfast when suddenly Daddy Bear found a spoon in his bowl.
"Someone's been eating my porridge."
They looked at each other, puzzled. On further inspection, Mummy Bear's porridge had also been tampered with.
"Someone's been eating my porridge."
Baby Bear looked into his empty little bowl and cried.
"Someone's been eating my porridge, and now it's all gone."
Daddy Bear went to sit down to think about how the porridge could have mysteriously disappeared, when he noticed his chair had been moved.
"Someone's been sitting in my chair,"
he exclaimed. Mummy Bear saw all her cushions on the floor and joined in.
"Someone's been sitting in my chair."
They all looked across at Baby Bear's chair.
"And someone's been sitting in my chair, and they've broken it," he cried.
They were still standing, scratching their heads, when they heard a faint noise coming from upstairs. Perhaps the intruder was still in the house. As they climbed the stairs, the noise became louder. Was it a mouse? Maybe it was a cat. No, it was a gentle snore. As they entered the bedroom, Daddy Bear noticed his pillows had been disturbed.
"Someone's been sleeping in my bed."
Mummy Bear also thought how untidy her bed was.
"Someone's been sleeping in my bed."
As they followed the snore round the room, they came to Baby Bear's bed. Although the blankets were over her head, Goldilocks' curls poked out on the pillow and gave her away.
"Someone's been sleeping in my bed," cried Baby Bear. "And she's still there. Look."
All three bears stared at Goldilocks. And as she stirred, she almost jumped to see three confused faces peering at her. At first she was very scared and wanted to run out of the house straight away.
It's okay,
they reassured her.
"Come downstairs and have a nice cup of tea,"
invited Mummy Bear. Goldilocks apologised about the broken chair and told the bears she would get her dad to fix it. Goldilocks was invited to come and join the bears for tea and honey any time she liked, as long as she always knocked first.